are we looking out for? Yes, Sasha. Okay, equal corresponding angles. As well as equal corresponding sides. Or length of sides.
Thank you.
think that it is congruent. Who would say it is not congruent? Okay, why do you say that it is not congruent? It is. Sorry. One thing is not corresponding. The sides are not corresponding. How do you expect the sides to be corresponding? What do you mean by the sides not corresponding? LM5CN, LM5CN, but are they not corresponding? They are equal, right? So, can you ask more what you mean by sides not corresponding? Any help from the others? Raise your hand. Rose, what do you think? Okay, Paul says they don't have equal corresponding angles. Okay, so it is something for you to take note about the vocab that you use. Okay, so sides being not corresponding, it's a bit vague. We're looking at the length of sides, but we don't have all the information, right, about the length of sides itself. Okay, so what Paul has decided to say is compare the angles. Okay, we have 60 degrees over here. We don't have any 60 degrees over here, so we may need to go and find it out. We do have 70 and it's 70 over here. Okay, so we have some information about the angles, but not all, right? In fact, there are only three interior angles in the triangle. We can find out what is the third interior angle, right? So maybe let's go and find it out first, because it is not right for us to assume that this is going to be 40 and then this is going to be 60, right? Okay. In fact, you will know that the angle sum of triangle is 180. Okay, you should know that if that is 40, it is at most 170. Okay, just by doing a very quick look at itself. But we still need to present our answers maybe. So angle L and M will be equals to 180 minus 70 minus 60. That will give us 150 inches. Okay, and that is how much we call our angle property that we learned last year, angle sum of triangle. Okay. Then we look for the third angle in our other triangle, that is angle YXZ. Okay, and we will get 70 degrees. That the corresponding angles, or rather there are no corresponding, equal corresponding angles. Okay, so how we go about computing, we can say that triangle LFN and triangle XYZ are not congruent. Textbook, page 9 for a better figure. of BC and BE. Now, the diagram that has been provided to you is challenging to actually observe because of the way that it is oriented. Earlier on, from the triangles that we have, it is not as challenging as what we have here because it is just a very mild rotation. See, 70 degrees and 70 degrees correspond to each other. Or in fact, the diagram that I've shown you over here, it is also in the same orientation itself. Okay, so there isn't any challenge in these two examples here. But if I list down four, okay, we need to be careful about the way we rotate and make sure we check. We cannot assume that, oh, this one is just the other way around, right? We got to check the vertices. Question says that triangle ABC is corresponding to CDE. So maybe let me do some color matching, okay, for us to visualize better. So A is corresponding to C. Okay, so A and C are the ones that are corresponding in the two triangles. Okay, then we have A. Then we have this B over here and this D over here. Okay, so it is this B that is corresponding to this D over here. Do you see that? Actually, it is not about rotating this triangle downwards because it's actually a flip over to the other side. Okay, so some of you might face that challenge, right, in visualizing and understanding a diagram. In such question is that draw out your own triangles in the orientation that will help you. What do I mean by that? Erase this. Because if you cannot visualize it correctly, you make the wrong assumptions and not answer will not be correct. So maybe you want to preserve the way the triangle CDE is actually arranged. Okay, so I'll draw a triangle CDE. I keep the information that has been provided. Right? Your diagram need not be accurate, it's meant to help you. Okay? Then we have CDE ready. It must match ABC. So I want to draw the exact same thing because it is congruent. Okay? And we know that CDE must be corresponding to ABC. First, then now I put in the information to this new triangle that I've drawn in different orientation. Question said here, AC is 18 cm. So in this diagram, AC 18 cm. I put in the information. Then the angle at B is 38 degrees. So angle at B, 38 degrees. So I have put in my information here. Put in the triangles here the information that I've given. It will make things easier for us to find out what is angle CDE, CED, and so on. Because we now know that if this is 38 degrees, W is also going to be 38. If W114, W is also going to be 114 degrees. Right? Okay? So now that I have assisted you in this, right, then you have to spend the next 5 minutes to go and figure out what is the answer to all these values.
Okay.
because you first try giving a name. Okay? Part 2, angle CED. Right, what is the answer for angle CED? Let's see. Chi-Chin. Yes, you hear? What is angle CED? Sorry? 28. Why is it 28? Okay? Yes. Thank you. I do expect complete presentation of answer, writing and telling me what is it that you're looking for and also the reason that you use. Okay? For the first part, there isn't a need for us to write a reason. Okay, we take it that it is due to the congruency of the need. Next, part 3. Okay, what is the angle ACB? Okay, angle ACB, okay. Okay, answer the question. What is angle ACB? Okay, I call your name, then you need to stand for someone. You all forgot already. Correct, right? Yes. Okay, so angle ACB, 28 degrees. Okay, so angle ACB is this angle here, which matches with this. So we found in part 2. So 28 degrees. Okay. Okay. here, and we have found that to be 28 degrees earlier on. So this is 28 degrees. And then over here, right, angle DEC, okay, is actually this answer in part 2, which is 28 degrees as well. Okay, so we see that the alternate angles are equal, therefore we can conclude that they are parallel lines. So how do we phrase this? We will say that AC and ED are parallel because angle DEC equals to angle ACE equals to 28 degrees, which satisfy the alternate angles parallel lines. Okay.